Taco. Eddie was called at Arthur Russell with Tim Cap. They headed to turn number three. The lights are off on the base car. Linda Corliss moves center stage on the starter stand. Green flag in hand. They come off turn number four. Ladies and gentlemen, it is showtime. These are the late models on Tour.
Get into his pits.
You guys are any
whatever happened to Nusara, it was immediate and final, because that thing just shut off. They're trying now to figure out exactly what's going on. Casagrande's in the pits in the one car and out. Monticello being looked at. Suspension being checked in the back. 71. Corey Pisacco out. The judge was there, but George Nusara is still with the hood up on the car trying to determine exactly what's going on or not going on with it, as the crew is looking, trying different things, but unfortunately they're not able to get to the cause of the issue back upstairs.
There is 10 laps up on the board, 22 laps ahead. Number 1 and 4 to say the least in this class as well. Michael Strazelli is wide for the industry of film and television, believe it or not, and she works on that race car with the setup. And she told me earlier tonight in the paddock area that she is very excited because every week they seem to get stronger and closer to their first victory. Tonight being the night, we'll look a little further back in the field. Tommy Fearn, who likes to be a spoiler and all of that. Adam Gray has the quickest big ponies beneath the hood. Let's see what's going to happen. Outside lane. Here comes Fearn. He'll challenge Gambacuda on the outside. JJ Hills comes further back. And looking strong again. Remember, he was a big car just a week ago. He's coming towards the front of the field. Meanwhile, Duran is there. And trouble now. There's a three wide battle on turn four. Circumstances before, and now he's coming back to the front of the field, and he has a wide
Strongly, look at Woody Pitcat. He is about ready to eliminate the top five.
Pitcat, no laps. to say the least, as we saw Cody Casagrande.
We're starting to get the latter stages of the race.
Thank you. honest with you, he is probably around 2,800 pounds.
I think Tommy Fern had to handle all that 2,800 pounds from Adam Gray as he wore like a helmet, and he still crossed the line. What a great finish. Hard-nosed racing, this is the reason people come to the tracks on Friday night, to see that intense, hard racing that we saw from Tommy Fern and Adam Gray.
And what about Woody Pitcat? He had no laps on this car tonight at all. This is the old car. He came from scratch. He passed more cars than anyone else. As we go to CarQuest Victory Lane and a very deserving Tommy Fern and Tony Sun.
Tom is out of the car. They a little liquid in. They probably lost during those laps. I'll tell you what. You were 13th back on the starting grid, and you came through that field like a warm knife. Well, thanks to Adam Gray, we ran real hard all night long, and he finished second, and I just happened to win, but he had a great car, too, and thanks for taking it easy on us. I got to thank King Ward and Safe Foot Foam. Stewie is here tonight, so I guess we'll dedicate this one to him. And, you know, Sun Valley Fire Equipment, they always step up when we need them. Rad Auto Machine, Buzzy Rear Ends, trainees by Dick Fern, and J.R. Sweetman from Agwam.
And Tom Fern for putting the gas down to the floor and steering this thing. That was a great race. It was fun to watch, and I'll tell you what, the excitement was for the entire 32 laps.
Well, I get the fun job. I get to drive the thing, so I got to thank my crew. They work hard on this car. Like I said before, I think our races are won in the garage. You know, a lot of time goes into these cars only in the garage. Got a good car, good crew, got a great spotter up there, my wife Sue, and hey, I can't thank these guys enough.
Congratulations on your win.
Thank you, Tony.
Well, Adam Gray is being congratulated by friends and family. Get over here. That was a race. No damage in your car, but you can see the touch marks on both sides of the front and on his rear and your rear as well. That was close racing.
Yeah, it's close racing. I mean, it's one that got away. We've been winning them in the shop, doing good. Thanks to my crew, all my sponsors, and we'll come back next week and get them, I guess.
Adam Gray, congratulations for putting on a great show, and congratulations for second place.
Thank you very much.
Well, we're waiting for Woody Pitcat. He's handing off his safety gear because he has to go jump into another car. You should be smiling. You drove from the very back of the pack after driving all the way up from Loudon, after qualifying fairly well up there, I understand, and then you finished third place here. You're going to follow it up in the next division?
I'm hungry. You got anything to eat?
We'll get you something to eat as soon as you can. In the modified, get out there and do your battle.
Yeah, no, that was a good run. I mean, that car's been wrecked, you know, in the last couple weeks. We came here and basically got a little bit of practice, Michael Bennett practice for me, and it was what it was, so I can't complain. We were a little bit snug. Got a fresh motor, Billy the Kid, great horsepower, Magnus transmission, BFR chassis, great chassis, New Haven Trucking Auto Body, everybody that helps on the car. You know, they busted their butts this week to get me this car, and it obviously shows. We'll try to fine-tune it and hopefully be a couple of spots ahead of us next week.
Woody Pitcat, a busy man this weekend. We wish you good luck in the upcoming races, and we wish you congratulations for a podium finish.
Thanks, Tony.
That's it from down here in Victor's Lane. We'll send it back upstairs. I'll tell you what, the hairs on my neck are still standing up from that one, because that was one of the most exciting late model races I've seen in a long time.